The Animal Welfare League on Sydney's Western Fringe is the home of second chances.
It's a little Australian terrier mix.
I don't even know what that is.
Here, dedicated staff and volunteers match the orphaned and abandoned with their forever families.
Hi.
Oh, hello.
Can't believe there's a crime.
And while sometimes it's a miss, there's no mistaking true love when it strikes. Straight to the heart.
My beautiful boy.
I love you.
Did I take you home?
At the Animal Welfare League, there's one type of dog whose excitement never wanes.
Worker breed. My favourite breed.
Ooh, Rumac.
If I was a dog, I'd be like them, and I think that's what probably draws me to them. Your typical working breeds are your Border Collies, your Kelpies, Cattle Dogs, your Australian Shepherds.
You ready?
Physical and mental stimulation is very important for any dog.
Good boy.
Come in, let's go.
And working breeds, probably a bit more.
Smart boy.
They want a job and they could go for a good 8-9 hours. When they come into our shelter, it's because people can't keep up with their energy needs. It's just too much for them and owners, they just can't keep up. Dogs come for us from quite a few different avenues. We have a big mobile vet truck who picks up dogs from regional pounds who have been abused and neglected. Once a dog comes into our care, it's super important to find out what the dog needs. A lot of dogs come in with their own little quirks and traits. Some dogs might take a week or two to trust us again after something bad's gone wrong.
Hello, beautiful.
Hi.
Oh, kisses.
Very affectionate.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Can you come off me?
Wow. Where did Aislinn come from?
So Aislinn actually came from Dubbo Shelter.
Do we have any history on her?
Not a whole lot of history. We don't know the background of where she came from before she ended up at Dubbo, but she was very nervous when she first came in.
Has she had any issues with people that you've noticed?
Just a bit unsure. When she first meets new people, being a puppy, we don't know how much she's been exposed to while she has been in the very first home.
She's quite confident taking treats off me here. Yeah. And being this food motivated, she should be pretty easy to train.
And she's so beautiful, as if someone's not going to fall in love with her.
Yes, I think there's a fair chance of that.
All right, brilliant. Thanks, Em.
I'll let them know that you're coming down.
Awesome, thank you.
Nick to Yellow Road. We got a...
Are we ready for a dog today? A big dog?
A giant one. A really, really big one.
We need a bigger backyard.
Siblings Taylor and Caitlin have spent months looking for their family's first dog.
Let's run this through. Little backyard means we need a smaller dog.
Yeah.
We want a dog that can run with us. So we need a dog that's big enough that we don't have to carry. I don't want to carry a dog. And who have we got? I'll start with you two.
My name's Caitlin.
I'm Tyler.
Mm-hmm.
Andrew.
Mm-hmm. Belinda. So who's the most excited for a dog today?
Me.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So then who's going to make the final decision?
Well...
Dad or Mum.
Through the voice of reason. The voice of sanity.
Wait, what's the voice
A world
of
without boundaries. The enabler. And I'll be the voice of reason.
Kitties.
That
is so cute.
Good morning.
Hi.
Good morning.
Hello.
Hi.
What are we doing here today?
Here to find a dream dog.
Oh, perfect. Exciting.
And what does that dream dog look like?
Depends on who you talk to.
Okay, so we've all got different opinions.
There's only four versions.
All right, well, let's go through
right.
What's your version of a dream dog?
A cat.
A cat? Right.
A cat dog.
A cat dog.
I would really like a cat. I prefer cats over dogs, but as nobody else in the family wants a cat, I will not be getting a cat. If I do find a dog that thinks it's a cat, I would be over the moon.
Maybe a boxer.
Okay.
Miniature schnauzery.
Boxer cross English bulldog. That's what you want.
Yeah, that's probably what I want.
I've just liked dogs since I was born. Dogs make me feel really happy. I know a lot about dog breeds because I research them.
We could do an A to Z of dog breeds and probably not miss too many.
Neapolitan Mastiff, Cane Corso, Great Dane, Pomeranian, Siberian Husky, Alaskan Malamute, Bull, Labrador Retriever, Bull Mastiff,
and on and on.
Which one's your favourite?
A Rottweiler.
And Mum?
I'd like a dog that fits in our backyard.
Right, okay. And speaking of, how big is said backyard?
We think we need a smaller to medium size.
Okay. So how high are we going?
About this big?
Okay. All right.
Oh, yes, thank you.
Yeah. So the boys want something that's a little bit bigger than the girls.
Yeah, and it's probably going to depend on the breed, the personality.
If it's a dog that's a bit bigger, that might be okay with a smaller backyard and it's a bit more docile. Would that be fine?
Yeah. So what other personality traits are we looking for?
I would like it to like water because I'll probably take it to the beach.
Because I'm a bit of a bookworm, so I would like a dog that can sit down and relax with me.
Our children are polar opposites in a lot of things. Cannon, she's quite shy.
Too big for his body most of the time. Oh, yeah, they're very different.
Very different.
Yeah.
And do we have any other pets at home, guys?
No, this is our first pet.
Tyler's wanted a dog forever, but there were lots of things we needed to accomplish before a dog was part of our family.
Yeah. Sure.
We set some milestones, and we've done those, and Tyler has worked really hard to have a dog in his life.
All right, I'm quite happy with all of that. We might go and have a chat.
I spent a lot of time with Tyler in his development, making sure that he was up to speed where he needed to be.
Now you're excited.
We're hoping the dog will also provide Caitlin with a bit of a reward for the sacrifice. She's me.
The dog is getting outfits a bit for sure.
No, Caitlin.
Two kids.
Yeah.
11 and 10.
Tyler and Caitlin.
Yeah. Yeah. Sweet. Okay, cool.
And the young chap, he said he wants a Rottweiler. Yeah. Parents wanted something a bit smaller. Prob's not going to place them with a young Rottweiler.
Wolfie might be actually really ideal for them.
Wolfie!
He's really cute and he's super social.
He's such a derp. Look at him.
He's this sweet.
What a goober.
He's so cute. He's quite young, so he's still 5 months old.
With Caitlin, she might be a bit scared of all the jumping up that he does, because he does jump up a lot. I was thinking Harley.
So he was an owner surrender.
I picked him up, actually.
Was the owner really sad?
Yeah, what's
that? She sat in the car for about 20 minutes hugging him because she didn't want to. It was totally out of their hands as well.
He's got such a woofy head on him. Look at him.
His head's like this, and you can just pet it. He's so cute. I feel like he'd be such a good dog with kids because he's just a smush.
He's going to be wanting to curl up on the bed with Caitlin while she reads her books.
Yeah, he is.
And for a first-time dog, he doesn't need a lot of training.
Yeah, for sure. Harley's a great choice. Let's get him out of the shelter. It's been here long enough.
Get a dog, Caitlin instantly becomes a dog person.
I could be like the crazy dog lady.
You could. that would freak me out so much.
Yes!
Hi! Well, that's a good greeting.
Okay, so we think we found you a unicorn dog.
He's a big dog, but the soul of a lap dog.
So a little dog in a bigger dog's body.
He's a staffy cross.
He's two.
And his name is Harley.
Such a cute name.
And I think he's going to be a great reading companion for you. And I think he's going to be happy to run around with you.
I'm already ready to meet him.
All right, cool.
Let's do it, guys. Cool.
Best of luck, Tyler. Straight to me and starts barking and then comes and tries to jump up on me. And then I'll pick it up and give it a nice hug.
See, that could be a miniature pincer. That could be a miniature pincer.
And a
Labrador.
Hi, baby boy. I can see your little toe sticking out. This is Harley.
Where'd it go?
He's a medium-sized staffy mix with a beautiful brindle coat with a splash of white in there. Good boy. Harley may have a little bit of an intimidating face because it is quite chunky, but he is a really well-mannered boy.
Hi, Harley.
He gets along with people and with other dogs.
Good boy.
And he's just the sweetest thing.
His name should be Harley the Roaring Dinosaur.
The Roaring Dinosaur Dog.
Yeah. It's taken us a while to get to this point. Because Tyler's been diagnosed with a condition called FAFA, and it's an acronym for a variety of different conditions with long medical names.
You can see where the dog's.
And for different children, it has different symptoms.
Okay, so
so excited.
For Tyler, it was very high temperatures. Would occasionally kind of pass out in his sleep. Very swollen glands, a mouth full of ulcers, a whole lot of different things that as a young child are not great to go through. Then as he got older and we worked out how to manage it, he was still obviously then playing catch up with school. As a parent, it's tough.
Twyla has put in the hard yards to catch up. It wasn't a learning difficulty. He just got off to a slower start.
I think he's going to be black.
Brown.
Brown.
Black.
Brown. So we set Tyler with a challenge. The deal was that when Tyler got to the point where he could read by himself, that he would then be ready to understand what a dog required.
Which bit's the most excited, Tyler?
My tummy going.
He has worked really, really hard, and I think it's more than a reward.
All right, I'm going to sit here really quiet.
I think it will make him a more complete Tyler.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
To meet 2-year-old Staffy Cross Harley.
Go, Harley!
Hi, this is Harley.
Hey, Harley.
He's so big. He's much bigger than I thought.
All right.
Oh my God, hi, Harley.
Look straight up. Hi, guys. I'm Harley. Look at my wiggle butt. Hi.
You're a very nice doggy, Harley. We all love you very, very much.
Aww. Yeah. He is like all about just love me.
Hey there, hi. You want to kind of?
Did you want to come say hi?
Go and say hi.
Oh yeah, he came up to me and gave me a big nice hug.
Oh, what's wrong with Caitlin?
I think she's a bit upset, maybe intimidated.
What's wrong?
I think she's scared of him.
He's way too.
Yeah, he can be a little bit strong because obviously he's a medium boy.
Haven't played with those.
It's difficult.
Oh, poor thing. She's had quite a negative reaction to him, hasn't she? He is definitely a lot bigger than a cat.
Yes.
Has she had any bad experiences with dogs?
She's not never had a dog.
No, okay.
So I'll hand out a little couple of treaties there if you want to offer him some.
Here you go, Hurley.
She's completely shut off, isn't she? She's totally turned away.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, he came up to me, gave me a big, nice hello.
Do you want to play a toy with this? Oh, we love toys as well.
Oh, yeah.
Good job.
I feel like Mum's not feeling it much either.
No, she's not. Doesn't look too impressed.
You ready? I'm gonna meet your best friend.
Charlotte and her pug Zeke are hoping to expand their family with another dog.
He's got his retirement, and I'm really hoping that we can find a friend for him, a little retirement.
I love Zeke. Hey, Zeke.
How old is he?
He's almost 13.
Oh, wow.
So he's an old fella. He's actually deaf and blind now because of his age.
I didn't even notice.
Yeah, no, he's got a good sniffer. I can imagine. In dog years, I think he's 91. Everyone who meets Zeke falls in love with Zeke. He's such a ball of cuddles and hilarious.
Zeke, you're going to have a new best friend.
Do you want me to hold Harley and you can come and pet him?
It's a bit sad because Harley is such a smushy, sweet munchkin, but just his size and his breed scare a lot of people.
It's a lot harder to bring home a large dog. We have a lot of dogs that come through our door and they're absolutely beautiful and they're big, buff heads, but a lot of people just rather a small dog.
Is there something in particular that's worrying you, or...?
Ken is probably finding Harley's size a little...
Well, even though he is a medium-sized dog, he is still incredibly friendly. He's always been really smoochy with most people that he meets. He's a lovely boy.
Cody's doing so well, isn't she?
Let's see how it plays out.
Come up and say hi if you like. So we're just remembering not to take the toy from his mouth, but you can definitely come say hi. Good job, Harley.
It's nice to see that Mum's willing to go over and give him a shot.
Yeah.
like a bit of a tiger, doesn't he?
What's he doing? Does he
look like a tiger? Look like a tiger. No, that's okay.
No, you like my feet.
So everything's looking nice and loose. He's got his nice, you know, wiggly bum and stuff like that. He's very sweet.
Okay, then good to see Harley playing with Tyler and like him being a smooch. She might go around, oh, you know what? He's not this big intimidating dog.
He might have sort themselves out.
It's just a sneeze.
Big sneeze. Oh, no.
Okay, she's not crying anymore.
He's doing a good job, Harley. Is that right?
Yeah, it's bucketing.
Huh. We might suck in here because it's a little bit wet.
Gonna get wet.
I would be happy with any sort of engagement from Caitlin, even if she doesn't want to, like, touch him. If she can throw treats at him, yeah, I'd still be happy with that.
All right, if you guys want to call him over.
Hey, Harley.
Good job, buddy.
How are they?
She's grown a little bit in confidence here.
Perhaps the rain forced her to interact.
Yeah.
Oh, he's like,
yeah,
but you gave
him
to me before.
Yes.
You've been sitting.
Yeah, like,
you sat.
Oh, good girl.
Oh, good girl, Caitlin. Well done.
And Harley.
Good job.
Yes, good job. Well done. Oh, that's so good.
You're welcome to offer him treats from there as well if you like.
Oh, she's going to give him a treat.
Sure.
Look.
Hand it nice and flat.
Harley.
Nice flat hand.
Oh, God. Oh, look at the smile.
Oh, she's going to give it back to him.
Would you guys be okay if I let him off for a second? Yeah. Caitlin, how do you feel about that?
Yeah, you can let
She's up. She's playing.
Massive
she's
going to
grab the toy. Oh, wow, she's picked up the toy. That's a big deal.
Hey, Harley. Ready? Go. Hey, Harley. Good boy.
I think maybe it was just a shock when she saw him for the first time.
Oh, he's got little wrinkles. They look like cat whiskers. That's what they remind me of. He's like, ooh.
Oh, yes, he wanted a cat dog.
It's a cat dog.
Yay! Is that a tick of approval from Caitlin?
So look, we already know what
I think that's his favourite toy.
Response and decision is, how does everybody else feel?
Well, positive, he looks like a cat. You know the positive, he's very playful.
I do. He is bigger than I expected him to be, honest.
Do you like him?
I think he's lovely.
So how would you guys feel about taking him for a walk?
Me.
There's part of me that's instantly in love with him because I'm ready for that. I just really have to sit down and go, is he the right dog for our family?
Ready, Harley, let's go.
We've got two very different children who have different expectations. I just need to know that everyone's in love with him.
I was glad that I got up and patted him because he is a really lovely dog.
And look at him, he is such a good walker. We know Harley's a really big smidge, and he's really good around people.
Good boy.
I hope these guys give him a shot.
He's really nice.
Today, the dog handlers will be doing a final assessment on Aislinn.
Aislinn came down to us, double-chill. When she came in originally, she was super timid. Huskies are quite an aloof breed.
Alright, I'll let her off.
Yeah, let her off. It takes a while for them to warm up to people, to get that trust. Come here. She's definitely timid. Once they do build that bond, it won't get broken.
In the kennel, I was able to lure her with treats.
You love your snacks, don't you?
Oh my goodness.
With Aislinn, once you build that trust, she's going to get back to you tenfold. Such a sweet dog. Come here. Hello. Hi. Oh, she's passed everything so far.
Sit.
We'll find you a home eventually.
Excuse me. Charity worker Charlotte is not just looking to adopt a rescue dog. She's interviewing for a retirement pal for Zeke.
Zeke has been there for me through everything. I would love for Zeke to have a friend. He's getting older, and I know that he won't be around. I know that he won't be around forever. But I also think that he could be such a good influence on a younger dog.
Hi!
You must have heard him barking.
Hello!
Hurry up.
Who is this?
This is Zeke.
Hi, Zeke. Sorry, hi.
Charlotte.
Nice to meet you, Charlotte. He's beautiful.
Yeah. How old is Zeke?
He's almost 13.
13? So, yeah. My gosh, you're fit for an old man.
Look at you. He's old, so he's blind and deaf now.
So he can't even hear us complimenting you, honey. No.
He can feel it in his soul.
That's right. He can feel the good vibes.
Yes.
How does he play then with other dogs?
My neighbor's dog, it's so cute. They just kind of walk in circles.
Looking for another one.
Zeke's getting old now, so I kind of thought it might be timing to have a retirement buddy, yeah, a little friend to hang out with.
What age are you looking for?
Given that he's quite old, I wouldn't want to take on another older dog just because I don't think I could deal with that much heartbreak in a row.
Yep.
Probably past the hectic puppy stage, but age isn't as important as their temperament. It's really, really important that any dog that comes into our life is going to be okay with Zeke. He's very outgoing, but he has got his disabilities.
One to five.
I mean, I'm flexible. I've been imagining a bigger dog that's going to be able to come on bushwalks with me.
So a bit more active?
A bit more active, but not too active.
Not bouncing off the walls, but can go on a hike.
And he's very happy to just lie around with Zeke, because that's pretty much what Zeke does. And I am quite an anxious person, so I don't know if a very anxious dog would make each other more anxious.
That can happen.
It can happen.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, if you're not feeling having a great day, your dog is not going to be having a great day.
Yeah.
So.
I'm a little bit nervous about it because it's just been me and Zeke for so long. Yep.
That's a fair emotion.
Yeah.
We've got a fair bit of info.
We'll be back in a moment.
Awesome. Yes.
See you soon.
Yeah. Okay. Yes.
See you second.
See you soon. No. I got Zeke when I was in my early 20s. I was living really far away from my friends. I just felt really lonely. My partner at the time and I, we went out and got little Zeke, and he's been with me ever since. So he's loved my life. I was married up until about 5 years ago to an absolutely wonderful human being. But I really don't think I was being my authentic self in that relationship.
Fine, sit there, I don't even care.
She feels like she's about to lose Zeke, and she's quite emotional about that. So she would like something that she can have, I guess, when she does lose Zeke, which is so sad.
Yeah.
Charlotte's only concern would be obviously if it's a really boisterous dog.
Yeah. Okay, so it's a calm dog for Zeke.
Yeah, I think 1 to 5, 1 to 4.
Okay, awesome. What size dog is she looking for?
She said medium.
Yes, she can picture herself with a bigger dog rather than a smaller dog.
She goes for bushwalks.
So. Okay.
I was thinking, since she already has a pug, we also have a pug with Kirk.
Yes. Kirk.
My only concern is she's not looking to replace Zeke.
Yeah.
So I don't want her to feel like if we offer her a pug that...
Might get a bit emotional.
Yeah.
She is quite emotional over Zeke, which is fair enough.
We do have another good option, Pepper, who came in.
She's 9, she's an Australian Terrier mix. Always on the go, she's young at heart, feels like she's always rushing to get somewhere.
She's a bit more calmer, so she might be really good for Zeke. And she does not act like a 9-year-old.
Activity levels.
Look, she is pretty active, but she was with quite an elderly owner.
So if Charlotte's taking her for that daily bushwalk, do you think that'll
she'll
be enough?
Her. Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Great. So her favourite thing of calm dogs, love and pats. Well, we have a calm dog here.
We have a calm dog,
That's quite good.
She's a pretty good match, I reckon.
Yeah, Charlotte have to compromise on that age, I know she was sort of looking for something around under 5.
Yeah, but terriers can easily live up to 18 to 20.
Yeah,
so the way she acts and the way she carries on, she acts like she's a puppy.
I think Pepper's the one.
Yeah, me too.
Of Zeke years and years and years ago, but he absolutely loses his mind for watermelon. So this is a tattoo of Zeke dreaming of watermelon.
That's beautiful. Wait, can you pull it up so we can see the full thing?
It's probably my most special tattoo.
Can Zeke see it from down there?
Zeke can't see anything.
Hello.
Hi.
Oh my gosh.
We think we have found you the right match.
Oh my goodness, please, please, please tell me. Zeke's getting excited.
So, I'm going to tell you. It's a little girl. Adores chilled out and calm dogs.
Yeah.
Just perfect for Zeke.
Okay.
She's a little Australian Terrier mix.
Only thing we'll have to compromise on, however, is she is 9 years young.
Okay.
A lot of our much younger dogs would have just been way too bouncy for little man, which is why we've gone a little bit older, but you wouldn't know she's 9. Yep. Terriers live a really long time. What was Sam saying?
20 years.
Oh, no way. So I could definitely have like a lovely
Like 10 plus
Absolutely.
Years.
Absolutely. So what's her name?
Pepper.
Pepper.
Yeah.
Well, that's a cute
like
name.
Pepper Pig. Zeke, would you like to meet Pepper?
Would you? Would you like to meet it?
We might hold on to your little gentleman here, so that way you can just spend some quality time with Pepper.
Before that, make sure you're not wet.
Oh, yes. Yeah, take that with you.
Okay, bye, Zeke.
We'll look after him.
Yes,
give him lots of snuggles.
So if you head straight down here and turn right at that meeting pen sign. Thank you.
Goodbye. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Say bye, Mom.
Pepper and the pug. The last 5 years have been quite a journey for me. I separated from my ex-husband and I decided that I really, really needed to start leaning into what I knew was my pansexuality or my queerness and start dating people of same and other genders other than men. Coming out in your 30s, it's been a journey, but I've never been happier. It's been a life-changing experience for me. I can be myself, and that's all I want to be. Just as hell deeply unhappy. I wish I'd seen more openly queer people. I wish that I had known how good it could feel to be 100% myself. I think I missed out on a lot. And I feel like I could have had much better relationships had I had the courage to be really open about it. Okay. Pepper.
Do you think?
Good, yeah. Actually, I did not think I would be this nervous.
Zeke is 150% the most important part of this whole scenario.
Yeah. Hey! No, you always go to talk to the ones when they're deaf.
So it's really important that whatever dog we end up adopting is the right fit for him.
Good kid.
I feel like treats are going to be important.
Come on.
Charlotte is hoping Australian Terrier Pepper might be the perfect match for her aging pug Zeke.
What do you think, Zeke? Zeke says,
come on.
Good girl.
Good.
Hi.
Oh my god, sorry, I'm gonna cry.
No, totally fine.
Oh, she's so cute.
Good girl.
Alright, you can just ignore me for a few minutes.
Let her have a bit of a sniff around.
She's probably gonna jump all over you. To just try and get it
okay.
A little bit.
Yeah. Oh my gosh, I'm already in love.
Oh, that's so good.
I will give this to you. Sit. Sit. Pepper.
Good girl.
Charlotte seems pretty good at getting out of sync when she's jumping up.
She's not overhandling her or talking down to her or anything like that. I'm really impressed.
Pepper. Sit. Wait.
I think with Charlotte's anxiety, Pepper might just be that dog that'll be able to help her through her anxious spells and get her through any tough days she might have. Not that you don't bring good vibes at all, wrinkle face, but, you know.
Some more.
Oh, you are so beautiful. Look at your beautiful face. Now, do you like pugs?
Are you ready to meet your new friend? Would you like to meet Pepper? Gonna meet your new sister.
Yeah.
Boys.
Oh, fine, mate.
When a dog does meet another dog for the first time, it's important to go quite slow.
Good girl.
Good girl.
The reason why I watch is because, you know, I know all the behavioural knowledge behind the dogs, so watching their body language.
Oh, look! Tim with his umbrella.
I love that.
The ideal scenario at the end of the day is that we want the dog as comfortable towards the dog and the people comfortable with the dog.
Hello. Hi.
My name is Sam, one of the shelter managers here at Animal
Nice
Welfare
to meet you. I'm nice Charlotte.
So what we're doing
now,
because obviously Zeke's blind and deaf,
yes.
We can get Pepper's come up from behind and
yep.
Have a sniff.
What?
love gown.
It's okay.
Come here, Zeke. Nice and slow.
Pepper's like, oh my god, let me play with him.
Yeah. And Zeke is like, I don't know what's happening.
Good. Oh, good girl. Good. That's too much in the face.
Pepper's pretty full on at the moment with him.
No. You're so excited.
Round the back, round the back.
Good.
Ooh. Oh, didn't Pepper.
She's very excited.
That's me. Good.
Yeah, she's gonna be
a lot. She's gonna be a lot.
Girl.
Let's not do that.
Oh.
You just punched Zeke in the face.
Charlotte, she looks nervous.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
You excited about getting this dog?
I actually am. I don't know if I can keep someone.
22-year-old Natasha is moving out of home. She's brought her dad Joe to help find a four-legged housemate.
I'll be on my own, so I just want a bit of companionship. Moving out from, I'm assuming...
Mum and Dad.
Mum and Dad. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Exactly. And two sisters. We'll have some peace and quiet finally.
Oh yeah.
So. Yeah, well, so are we.
Thanks. See what I have to deal with.
I'm pleased for her. I think it's very important to get that independence from the family.
Thank you, sir. It's all right. We'll take a seat.
But Natasha is the baby.
Someone stepped on his foot.
I will miss that companionship.
Pepper's very excited.
Yes, she is. Good.
Ooh. Oh, didn't like that.
Pepper has gotten off to a wobbly start with Charlotte and Zeke.
She's going to be a lot for Zeke.
Yeah, yeah.
How long do dogs normally sort of take to get used to each other when they...
It just depends on the dog itself. So if you've got two really social dogs, they can literally, within 5-10 minutes, they can be off lead together.
Okay.
What I might do, Kat, I might let Zeke off.
I like this.
Not a bad thing.
And then Pepper can
follow after him a little.
Meet and greet, what's she doing?
Careful.
Pepper just needs to understand that Zeke is not that playful dog.
It's okay.
She doesn't really want to follow him now.
It's a good sign that she also decided to walk away.
Oh, I think she's picked up it actually.
Yeah.
Take it off.
Yeah, take it off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Next level.
I'm gonna take Zeke off.
Good girl.
Oh, straight. That was an accident.
Okay.
So what she's doing, she's checking in on him, which is good, and she walks off.
Yeah.
Which is nice. Now she's walking past him, completely fine.
Didn't jump on him.
That was literally a sniff and then a walk off.
Perfect.
Can read dog. Good girl.
Hey, Zeke. Tell me, do you like Pepper?
Hi.
Oh, she's beautiful and so are you, Zeke.
Aww. Cute. These two dogs are doing really well together.
We'll take them for a walk.
Yeah.
Head on back.
Walkies.
I think Zeke has fallen in love with Pepper, and Pepper loves Zeke, and it's a boyfriend-girlfriend.
Good girl. Come on.
Zeke will hopefully calm Pepper down a bit. I'm really hoping that Pepper will bring out a more playful side in Zeke.
Next river.
But I think Pepper's energy and Zeke's energy... It's probably going to be like a yin and yang. I don't know how it's going to go. It could be challenging.
Come on, Pepper.
Come on.
I'm so fat. Oh, my God.
Oh, man. It's going to help when you get a dog and he takes you for a walk all over the place.
Natasha and her dad, Joe, are looking for a change of lifestyle.
Hopefully with this dog, I will be really active. Every day walks, I do want to try and lose weight. Hopefully I'll lose like 10 kilos.
If you lost 10 kilos, you slip between the floorboards, you'd be like a super weight.
I think I need a bit more than 10 to slip through the floorboards.
Hello.
Hey.
Oh, hey.
Hi, guys.
Good.
So you guys are here to get a dog today?
Yes.
For me.
For Natasha.
For you. Do we live together though?
At the moment. But in a few months, hopefully I'll be moving out.
And if she doesn't move, I'll kick her out.
That'll
be fine.
Are you going to miss your dad when you move out?
Yeah.
The cooking.
Oh, and the cleaning. I miss that.
And the everything.
Oh, yeah.
There'll be a few things. I will miss my dad a lot. He is my buddy 24/7.
I'm a wing person. Support.
Yeah, I have a very good dad. He really tries to give us the best opportunity possible.
Hopefully a big dog.
dog.
So why a big dog? Most people are after the smaller ones.
Because we live on some land.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm not too fussy on breeds, because as long as you treat them well, they're going to treat you good.
Absolutely. And what kind of life is it going to have with you?
It's going to have a really good life with me, not going to lie. I feel like the dog's going to constantly be with me. Everyday walks.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
It's not going to have a lot of downtime.
Well, that gives us a lot of options. We might go and have a chat.
Thank you so much.
Hey, Gab.
Yay. Don't care. Big dog. I don't care about anything else.
What are you guys thinking?
Well, I was thinking Maggie.
Oh, she's so beautiful. She's a 2.5-year-old Maremma sheepdog. She is like one of those dogs you look at and you're like, I just need to touch you.
She's like a marshmallow with legs.
Yes.
I just worry with Natasha. I think she wants a dog that's going to push her to do more exercise.
Just not quite the right fit this time. There is one other option, and that's Aislinn.
Oh, I love Aislinn. She's quite boisterous.
So Aislinn is 6 months old. She's a husky cross. She's got those beautiful blue eyes. So she's an interesting one.
Yeah.
So she's a big goofball. She's one of those dogs who she'll come approach you and then go, nah. And then she'll come back when she's comfortable and she goes, I don't get you.
Yeah.
In a friendly way.
Yeah.
Jumps all over the place.
Sure.
But it's just basic training, Nick. She is a smart dog. Won't take very long to get a structure and routine in place.
Let's jump on this opportunity to get a high-energy large breed out.
Let's do it. We've narrowed it down to one beautiful lady. She is quite young. She's only 6 months old.
Yeah. Okay.
And she's going to be a bit of a project for you, actually. So she needs ongoing training.
Can be a bit of a scaredy cat with new people at first, but then once she gets to know you, she will, like, physically jump on you and be like, hi. So her name is Aislinn.
That's cool.
And she's a husky mix.
Oh, well.
I'm excited. And she's quite interesting looking.
Sounds cool.
If you're after an active dog that's going to get you out of the house and exercising, that's her, because she's full of beans. At least one good walk a day and quite a longish walk.
Yeah, I would go an hour, I think, especially at 6 months of age.
Sounds like it will be a good fit.
She is going to get you really fit.
Yeah.
That's what it needs. This will be a good match.
In a week.
Aislinn, this way.
Good job. Aislinn came to us from a regional facility. And huskies do tend not to cope as well because they're so intelligent and so outgoing and they need so much stimulation. This is a huge chance for Aislinn to find a family.
Come here.
Someone that can work with her and just absolutely love everything about her.
I danced for 12 years and then once I stopped in year 12, my exercising has definitely gone down a lot. So ready for this. I've lost a lot of my confidence. Now that I'm moving out, having this dog will make me feel a bit more confident, always having someone and lots of happiness.
Yeah. Aislinn.
Oh, my dog's here.
Good job.
Oh my God, he's already massive.
This is Aislinn. He's probably going to have a bit of a sniff around.
I'd have a sniff.
Oh, a bit of a startle response.
She does that when she meets new people. Yeah. She's a bit skittish at first, yeah.
So this might stay here for a little bit.
Yeah.
Just while I let her settle and get used to you.
Hello.
Oh, just be careful patting her face.
Yeah,
she's skittish. Oh, she's got a bit of a tail tuck.
All right, I might let her off and just let her have a little bit of a sniff around.
Here you go, honey.
So she is. She's very young still.
It's a lot meeting new people, especially when you're that age. And she's not had the greatest start in life coming through the shelter system and the pounds and everything. So people are scary. People haven't necessarily been the greatest thing in her life so far.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Yeah. All right, if you guys need anything, just yell out.
No worries.
Yeah, okay. Let her do her thing for a while.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, well, she's decided to go and sit right by the door with her tail
tucked underneath her. So she's feeling quite uncomfortable, I think, with the interaction right now.
Yeah, there's quite a big clown mouth. She's panting as well.
Addie, look.
She's just unsure at the moment.
I know. Oh my god.
Ooh. Yeah.
Husky cross Aislinn might be everything that Natasha is looking for.
Wants to keep exploring.
But Aislinn...
To place Aislinn, you need patient people. You need people who are going to take their time and they're going to be okay with a dog that's not perfect from the get-go.
Nah, she just wants to explore.
It's just going to take time.
Yeah.
And it's just whether these guys are patient enough.
The water.
Well, she has to feel safe enough if she's getting in the water there.
What's she chasing?
I don't know if she's chasing or if she's struggling to get out. There you go. Oh, she's back. Oh.
Yeah, that's good, eh? How good's that? What's the water?
She's so cute.
Come, Aislinn. Oh my god.
Oh, clumsy girl.
Because he's wet. Oh, Aislinn. Oh, I think she's warmed up a bit now.
I think so. Got a good feeling about this one.
Yeah.
Ready, Aislinn? Go, ready? Here, look. Go. This is what I need, though. Come. Oh, where's the ball?
This is what Natasha wanted. Look, she's running around with her.
Woo! Go. This is the motivation I need. Oh, where's the ball? Aislinn, let's go. Oh, yes, bring it back, bring it back. Oh, ready? Let's go. Let's go. Go. So definitely we'll have to have like a shell.
I think so.
Look at how she jumps.
I think she's warmed up. Gloves on.
Oh, that's awesome. Do you want to take her for a walk?
Yes. I think Aislinn is the right kind of dog for me. She's big, energetic. It's going to help me through my loneliness when I move out.
Aislinn, this way.
She just needs to warm up to her surroundings and then obviously me.
Girl. Ooh. Oh.
I didn't quite know what to expect with Pepper. Bringing a high energy dog into a home with quite an elderly pug, I just wasn't sure what was going to happen there. Zeke! Pepper! Come here. There's energy. I thought she's just going to be all over him 24/7, but she calmed down significantly. I was really hoping that Pepper would add some pep to Zeke's step. He kind of hasn't. Zeke's every day of his 13 years old.
Pepper, come here.
I take Pepper bushwalking every day. It calms me down, it calms her down, it's perfect. And I've taught her to jump up on my favourite rock that looks out across the mountain view, and we'll just sit there and relax, just enjoying the view of the mountain. I'm really glad that I took Pepper home. She's such a beautiful dog. Zeke's happy. That's the biggest thing for me.
Oh, you're too gorgeous.
There was a risk in bringing Aislinn home.
She was a bit wary, and I knew that would maybe be a problem.
You don't want a dog that's not going to fit into the family.
But she warmed up straight away.
She's been a really lovely dog. She's cheeky and she likes to sneak into the house whenever she can. Wasn't sure whether Natasha was going to stop to
the responsibility, but she certainly has.
Wait. Go. Go. The most trying thing's toilet training. She has a favourite spot to go, and it's not on the grass. It's on the veranda.
She needs to be trained. Can't be doing
it. I know. That's why she's gone to puppy training.
And she has. Yeah, so she'll be good.
So hopefully she'll be a bit better. Aislinn. Aislinn is 100% a goofy dog. She loves bugs. Go. And she doesn't eat them. She'll just pounce on them, trap them in a ball, let them go, wait for them to walk a bit, pounce on them again. Very goofy. Aislinn, look. Before I had Aislinn, my exercising was very stop, start, stop, start. Now I have to go on a walk. She needs it. I need it. I couldn't imagine my life without Aislinn. She's the perfect dog for me.
When she does leave home, I think it will be quite emotional, but Aislinn's a perfect companion for Natasha. AWL's done a really good job.
You're such a good girl.
Meeting Harley, we did go in with an image in our minds of what we wanted to come away with. Harley initially didn't fit that bill at all. He was big, he had a big head on him. We fell in love with him, and he was just the coolest dog ever.
I think we could have been really happy with Harley, but I don't know whether Harley would have been really happy with us, whether we would have had the time and the space and the energy to run him. I think we spoke about Harley all night.
There's a few tears.
We sadly decided not to take Harley. Lila! We are so happy she's part of our lives.
To be honest, Lila, I think, is better than a cat.
Was it? Ready?
Go get it. She is definitely a lot more active, and she's definitely very cuddly and sweet.
Good girl, good girl.
Lila's excited, energetic, and plays with you and likes to cuddle. I'm really, really happy. I still think about Harley because Harley was a really, really nice dog.
Hi, Harley.
Good boy.
Next time on The Dog House, will messy mutt Harley finally be rescued?
He has only got one eye, but I think it's kind of cute.
And things get tense in the pen.
It's all right.
I don't like that.
As nervous dogs.
What you doing, mate?
And humans.
Mum's never really wanted a dog.
See, Mary, she's still a bit fearful.
Look for everlasting love.
Come on, Banjo.
My beautiful boy.